There is one. Wow, that looks really good. London, here we come. On average, I would say most people lead a pretty busy life. At least people I'm around. You know, working, and then when they're not working, they're spending time with friends, family, partners, dogs, workout classes, whatever the fuck busy people do. And typically they then take vacations, where they spend time relaxing, alone, quiet. For me, it's pretty much the exact opposite. Now, that's not to say I don't have friends, family, dogs, etc. that I love. I do. But I work from home, and then when I'm done work, I sit over there, sit in bed, do nothing. Which, you know, I love my alone time, but based on the previous statement, my math would be correct to assume the idea of vacation for me would be somewhere loud, outgoing, vibrant. But math has its flaws, you know? Like severe social anxiety, the fear of leaving this 1 centimeter by 1 centimeter room, you know, all the things. But I do love a good, like, New York City, and now, spoiler alert, London. But, you know, there's still the crippling fear of being somewhere you've never been with people you don't know, and that can be overwhelming. And oh boy, was it overwhelming. I'm an overthinker in its purest form. If I'm walking somewhere that I'm unfamiliar with and then realize that I have to turn around, instead of just turning around, I will go down one street and then down another so I can walk in the opposite direction. Because if I just turned around, it would attract attention that I don't want, and I would be so embarrassed, even though literally nobody cares. If I'm meeting up with a friend, and they think I'm gonna come from one direction, but I'm actually coming from the other for whatever reason, I will take the long route to make sure it looks like I'm coming from the direction that they think I'm coming from. All this to basically say I'm not like other girls, blah blah blah, but also to give you some insight into what would be going through my mind this whole trip. When my mom and I flew in, Mary had no idea I had company. So we surprised her, and it went very well, if I do say so myself. Hey!
Sorry I'm late!
London gal!
What?
What are you doing here? Gotcha! But quickly after arriving, the delusion was really setting in. I was so tired. I didn't sleep on the flight like I thought I was going to. I think I did for maybe like 20 minutes, 30 minutes total. So I was not well. I literally felt unconscious for the rest of the day. And if I didn't film what we were doing, I would genuinely have no idea what happened that day if somebody asked me. I would go, you know what, I was asleep the whole time, even though I was awake walking around and doing things. But we went to this pub called The Camel.
What about a beverage? What do you want?
It's a pitch perfect move. It's Glee.
Oh, it's Glee.
Because we decided it would be a good idea to get some pies. And I'm not talking apple, pecan, pumpkin. I'm talking liver. Okay, I don't even know if that was an option. Steak, whatever. But of course, I got the vegetarian option because it was the least intimidating to me. And so did Mary, and my mom got the classic, you know, steak. We then decided it was probably not a good idea to do anything super crazy that day. We had just got there. Obviously, the time difference was weird. So we walked around Shoreditch, where we got some yummy coffee and checked out some charity shops.
Hey, It's all zoomed in.
That was not intentional.
Come on, mate. Get out of the way.
You're gonna offend someone so fast.
Am I? I'm gonna ruin this camera. Taste test.
Literally nothing came up. Like, my straw's broken.
It looks broken. Okay, I'll taste test. Can you film me?
Tastes like a latte. Give it a...
I hope you can hear me breathing in the background.
She's like, 7.3 out of 10.
7.3 out of 10?
Yes, because it's good coffee and good cream, but I'm not getting a lot of vanilla.
Fair.
But it's still good.
Good. I'm gonna go get another straw.
Okay.
Tea taste test.
Oh, too hot.
Okay, we'll be back with the tea taste test. Oh, wait.
Mine's vanilla-y. You want to try this one? Switch. I'll take mine. They're selling stickers for here, but I grabbed some from the other place. Same for you. Same stickers. I don't know if I have them with me or if they're at home.
Can you show the mug, Mom?
Stickers,
mm-hmm.
And they're the Starbucks logo, but it says Fuck Coffee on it. I think I took a picture of my coffee for my Be Real, and it was on the thing.
Me exposing your Be Real.
The reason I probably have to pee so much is because I didn't pee the entire plane ride.
Okay, pee, Lord.
And water.
Nice.
I'm walking and working and all out, you know?
I do know. Live reaction.
See the necklace?
2023 be like. I'm just kidding.
I'm trying to get us tickets to an event.
I'm kidding.
I woke up refreshed after going to bed at 7 p.m. because I genuinely could not keep my eyes open. But this was an exciting day. It was concert day. Because we had pit tickets, not to flex or anything, we thought it'd be a good idea to just spend the day at the O2 before lining up. And I knew the O2 was a big venue, but it was actually cool. Like, they have, it's like a big mall where you just walk around. There's food everywhere, there's stores, and lining up was inside, which was also nice because it was so cold. That night, though, girl, I was miserable. I was miserable. And the only way to describe the vibes I was giving off were Miss Trunchbull. Like, I could not have been more miserable. I would, not actually, but I would, like, want to punch anyone that came into my close vicinity. And we were at a concert, so, well, it was after the concert, but we were having a hard time figuring out how to get home, and I was cold. Tired, needed a winter coat, but was really just wearing nothing. And instead of helping in the process of getting us back to the hotel, I just kept being like, I need to be home right now. I need to teleport. I need to be not here. And I need to be in a bed. But I just sat there and made Mary do all the work because I'm just so delightful. So babes, I really did not help in that process, but we made it back. Following the night of the best concert I've ever been to was more exciting plans, as one does on a vacation. Tattoos! But we'll get back to that because I want to keep it a little suspenseful. We didn't really have any set plans after the tattoos, we just kind of wanted to go somewhere nice and get some good food. So after some speculation, we decided Covent Garden was the spot.
Hey Mom. What are you taking pictures of?
The Bethel Green sign.
Let's dox her.
Isn't it gorgeous?
Uh-huh.
And I'm so glad we did, because our tattoo artist, Robin, recommended this Italian place that I will remember for the rest of my life. And I'm being so serious. I'm being so serious when I say that I had the best fettuccine Alfredo I've ever had. Ever? Like, actually ever. And I still think about it almost every day. It was so delicious. The pasta was fresh. The sauce was like no other that I've ever had. And the fresh Parmesan, I can't. Like, I actually can't. It was so good. And this felt like a really nice moment because we were just together eating good food. And I wasn't thinking about anything other than eating that food and being with, you know, those people. AKA my mom, my sister, you know, with the whole overthinking and anxiety thing. Moments like that don't happen often. This amazing lunch was then followed by a literal string quartet. Like, come on. You don't see that kind of stuff every day.
What did you get?
Vodka and Coke.
Cheers.
To London.
To London.
Put something on your shirt.
Camera eats first.
Beautiful, thank you.
Watching this is like, Helen, please, we're begging you to just show us the tattoo process. We've been waiting. The suspense is killing me. Okay, fine, fine. I will deliver. Now, anyone who knows me will know that with any chance I get, I will bring up politics. We went from talking about Maddie Healy eating raw meat to The Simpsons to toxic masculinity and Andrew Tate. And then to, like, kids shows. Thankfully, Robin was lovely, was seemingly on our side for, you know, the politics stuff. And of course, I'm obsessed with the tattoo. You've had a little peek the whole time. And now I have a literal permanent memory of this trip forever, apart from the aforementioned fettuccine Alfredo.
Best part of tattoos.
Yeah.
That hypnotic state and the afterwards euphoria.
It's the only time I ever let myself sit and do nothing is when I'm getting tattooed.
Oh yeah, he did the infamous eating the raw meat on stage also.
Yeah.
Great for all the vegans in the crowd.
Yeah.
Who did that?
Maddie Healy.
He like in some cities like did it in New York, LA, and then here.
Generations getting a lot more involved at voting more than my generation ever did.
You'd be surprised though at how many people my age are still like conservatives.
That's because they're still listening to their old school parents too though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Right, I'm just gonna pack this away. I'm just gonna let that air out a little bit, let it calm down.
Okay, come closer and I'll get a photo for you. I'm literally just doing
that. I know. My glasses were like on my eyelids the whole time.
Is The Simpsons a thing anyone?
Yes.
We made our way to the first of our truly touristy adventures, if that's what you want to call it. And we headed to Trafalgar Square because it wasn't very far. But we rested here for a little bit, just kind of people watched and sat there.
Have a good day. Have a good afternoon.
What the? Oh.
So shortly after that, we were off to big old Ben himself. Now this was a sight for sore eyes, if I do say so myself. It was busy, very busy, but so beautiful. You always see those types of things in pictures, obviously, and you know they're beautiful. That's why people take pictures of them, that's why they are like monuments, that's why. Still, in person, it was just such a cool experience to see Big Ben. Like, it's literally a big clock, but still, I don't know, something about it was just different. Focus.
There is a gift store. Shrek's gift shop.
It's too far.
And then I got to see Peyton finally. By this day, and if we're keeping track, is day 4, my body did not like me. I was tired and my feet were sore, so I decided, you know what, it's a good idea for us to reunite by going to a museum. In theory, it's a perfect plan, but on the inside, I was in physical pain. But it didn't matter, because all that mattered to me in that moment was seeing Peyton finally in London, getting lunch together, going to this museum, and seeing her felt like nothing had changed in a way. You know, when, you know, you don't see someone for so long, and then when you do, it's like they'd never left. It felt like that, and it was just so much fun to see her and to catch up. It felt like when I would text her from literally the next room over to see if she was busy, and if she wasn't, I would storm into her room and watch whatever episode she had of Keeping Up with the Kardashians on, because unless she was reading or sleeping, that was on the TV. But then it would turn to us talking about these deep topics or secrets that we would always talk about and just agree with each other on everything. You know, that kind of friendship. So I missed her dearly, and I do already miss her again, because I wish I could have seen her for longer. Oh, and the museum, it was pretty cool too. And after a sad and difficult goodbye, it was time for me to go back to the hotel and rest my eyes for about 30 seconds before going to drag bingo. Now, you would expect it to be bingo, but in drag, and that's what it was, but still, there was something in me that was like, what am I really, like, what is gonna happen at this drag bingo? And I was not disappointed. It was so much fun, and it was very interactive, which was super cool, but also, if you chose to not be interactive, it was still really fun. I was having a more chill mood, so I didn't feel like getting up on stage and lip-syncing, but that was a thing that could have happened, and it looked so much fun up there, but I also had a lot of fun sitting back, and it was cool to immerse myself into a little bit of the London drag scene, because I've only really ever been to Canadian drag stuff, so that was awesome. It was epic. Now, it wouldn't be a trip to London without a trip to Paris, you know, as they say. But in reality, not but, I still had an amazing day. being in Paris was actually perfect. And similarly to Big Ben, seeing the Eiffel Tower was so weird in a way. Like, I felt feelings in my body I couldn't describe. I saw it and I was just in awe, even though I've seen thousands of pictures of that thing. I don't know. It was just so cool to see something like that in front of my own eyes. I've always wanted to go to Paris, so it was just amazing. And to be there with my mom and sister was just really special. And that day, I was trying so hard to have a good day and not ruin my mom and sister's day, because I felt so tired that I started to get fever symptoms, and I didn't know that was a thing until it happened. But I was freezing, like, so cold. I was freezing cold, and my mom was sweating, and I'm like, what is going on? Normally, I'm the one profusely sweating, but I was freezing, like, shivering so cold. Can't describe it any other way other than freezing cold. Thought I was gonna get hypothermia. But funny story about Paris is that the moment we got there, we were scammed. We were scammed. I'm embarrassed to admit it, but I'm being authentic when I say we were scammed. And it was funny because in the moment I was really confused. Like, it didn't kind of click to me that we were being scammed until the people left, and my sister immediately was like, okay, so they just scammed us. And I was like, oh my god, they did. And then when I got back home after this trip, I was scrolling on TikTok, and of course do I not see a video on my timeline being like, five scams to look out for in Paris. And it was the first one on the list. Now, do I want to get into detail about what we got scammed for? Sure. These people came running up to us. I think it was like three people, and they had clipboards. And they were like, do you speak English? And we were like, yep. Clearly we're tourists. I have like a camcorder out, like filming things, looking around, just standing in the middle of this like median, basically. They come running up. Do you speak English? We're like, yep. They're like, we are this organization for deaf and blind kids. Like, can you just sign here and donate or whatever? So I, like, sign my name, like, literally sign it, and it's asking for, like, my postal code, and, there was, like, other, like, weird, very personal information on there, and I'm like, okay, my dumbass is filling it in, and then they're like, oh, the minimum is 20 euros. I had zero cash on me, like, not a penny, nothing, and I'm like, oh, I don't have anything, and then they start to get, like, a bit angry. And they're like, not even Canadian, not even pounds, nothing. And I was like, no, like, I don't have anything. And then they kind of like, it just was like very chaotic. So I just kind of stood there and like waited for them to leave. And I don't know how much money my mom gave them, but I don't want to know how much money my mom gave them, if I'm being honest, because that was, it's a funny memory, I guess, but hopefully they don't track me down or something because I gave them my postal code. I don't know.
Let them meet. Back from Paris. Not even back. Just going.
Just going.
I'm so mature. I don't wanna, I just want you. If I can have you, no one will. How am I? I'm like your wife, the best idea is new girlfriend's next. How do I get here? I'm like your wife.
Are you happy to be in Paris?
Oui.
First floor we see. It's alright.
Thank you.
for our final day in London, we decided it would be a good idea to sleep in, take our time, and do some shopping. We went to Carnaby Street, which was really cool. It was nice. It was modern, but still genuine feeling. It wasn't a long day either. We kind of just shopped and then went back to the hotel. But before we kind of wrapped things up, we were like, obviously we have to find fish and chips, especially for my mom. Mary's vegetarian and I'm not a huge fish girly, but we were very determined we had to find some, and we found this perfect little place. I'm so upset I don't remember what it's called. If I do, I will insert it. I had like chicken strips or something. It was really good. Long story long, it was really good, and my mom was satisfied, which I was happy about. And that's kind of where everything ended off. We collected our things, went to the hotel, and slept there for one last night before heading home.
Look at how she holds that camera.
Oh, Jesus.
Ow. You alright?
Yeah, I was literally recording.
Now you might be wondering, Helen, what did you learn on this trip? I learned many things, but one that really stuck out to me is to really appreciate the moment while you're in it and to be as present as possible, because it's hard. I'll never be in London at that exact time with those exact people ever again, and I wouldn't change a thing despite, you know, the stuff that maybe wasn't on camera, because again, you're traveling with a bunch of mentally ill people. It's not all sunshine and rainbows, even though I so badly wanted it to be sunshine and rainbows, and trying to force it actually, at least for me, made me feel worse. So it was hard. It was so much fun, and not to take away from this amazing experience, and, you know, a girl like me doesn't get to travel much, so that was a huge deal, and it was my first time in Europe. It was so beautiful, and I will cherish it forever, but again, it's just not all sunshine and rainbows. You know, the behind the scenes isn't perfect. I don't know what I was trying to do with this whole thing. With like a script. It's literally 4 pages. I don't know who I think I am. The moral of the story is, if you're the type of person that does a London accent or a British accent for fun, you're gonna have a hard time in London, and I'm being so serious. The amount of times I wanted to do this anytime I heard somebody else speak like this, oh my god, it was painful. It was painful. In line at the 1975 concert, you know when like people camp out a little bit and they sit there and they've got like food, but once the line starts moving, you can't bring anything in. So there was a bag of cheese balls. There was a bag of cheese balls on the ground as we were walking by, and there was a person in front of me, and they look at the bag, and at the same time as my sister, she goes, "Cheese balls? Oh my god." I just thought, she needs to leave. We need this line needs to move so that once we're separated, I can just continue to repeat "cheese balls" over and over again, because I needed that. It actually made my trip. I think that was my favorite part. Cheese balls. Bye, London. Miss you, girl. This accent is inspired by Gemma Collins. It's not very good, but I tried. Bye, London.